गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून होम्योपैथ्स, द कलीग्स, द प्रैक्टिशनर्स, द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द होम्योपैथी एंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर दिस सेशन ऑफ बायोकेमिक सिस्टम ऑफ मेडिसिन। यस्टरडे वी हैव डन अ फेसबुक सेशन ऑन कालीफॉस्फोरिकम एंड वी हैव लर्न सर्टन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ कालीफॉस। I know that there are number of newcomers on this session also, and that's why I want to just revise a short within 2 minutes, one slide, whatever we have learned regarding the theory of biochemic system of medicine. So 12 tissue salts maintains the harmony at cellular and tissue level, because cell is the unit of the human body, and if balance is maintained at the cellular level, the person is called to be healthy. If they are in proper quantity, the chemico-physiological equilibrium is maintained at the molecular level. Their molecular motion is maintained, and this maintained harmony maintains the health. And this is the concept of the health according to the Schüssler. If there is a deficiency of any salts or salts, and it reflects in the disturbance of molecular motion of at the cellular level or a tissue level, which disturbs the equilibrium and expresses in the form of signs and symptoms, and a disease happens to be there. This is the concept of a disease according to the Schüssler. And lastly, he says over there, if you provide the required salt in a minimum quantity, that is in semi-dynamic doses, at the level of a molecules, the molecular equilibrium is again maintained and health is restored. So simple logic, simple concept, simple understanding, the concept of a health, disease and a cure that has been mentioned in the theory part of the biochemic system of medicine. And then we have learned up till now the 6 remedies. The Calcarea Pleura, we have started with the Calcarea Pleura, Calcarea Fos, Calcarea Sul. Then the Ferrum Fos and 2 Kali salts we have finished up till now, that is Kali Muriaticum and Kali Fos. For the newcomers, I will advise that they should refer to the YouTube channel, subscribe the channel and go into the playlist and find it out, the biochemic system of medicine. You will get all previous videos in detail and you can learn regarding those remedies. So I will not share a lot regarding all those remedies, just in simple language. Calcarea Pleura is the remedy which has specific action for the bones, the teeth, in the teeth, then in the degenerative forms, then in the muscular coats of the vascular wall, and that's why pathology is always related with this in the form of a degeneration, the osteophytes formation, the caries of the teeth, the hanging belly, the elasticity of the abdomen is lost, and lastly the veins, varicose veins or hemorrhoids. These are common things which we used to get in Calcarea Pleura. Second remedy we have discussed is Calcarea Fos, which plays very vital role in the formation of cells and tissues, and that's why it is basically a content of the hemoglobin molecule formation. Calcarea Fos plus Natrum Mur plus Ferrum Fos together forms the hemoglobin molecule, and that's why it is a regeneration. For the purpose of regeneration, this plays a very vital role. It is present in number of parts in human body, and that's why there is a wide spectrum of action of a Calcarea Fos is there. Basically in the fractured bones to form the callus, Calcarea Fos plays very vital role. So in the cellular development, in the growth, generally for the purpose of increasing the height or proper development, proper growth, Calcarea Fos plays very vital role. Third remedy which we have discussed is the Calcarea Sul, the third stage of inflammation. The first part of a third stage of inflammation is covered under the Calcarea Sul. In fact, very small amount is present in bile, and if there is, it works as a function, as a those RBCs which are worn out, which are already necrosed, the water content is absorbed with this Calcarea Sul, and then these RBCs, destructed RBCs, can be taken away through the circulation, through the vessels or lymphatics, and that debris is taken away with the help of a Calcarea Sul. If it is missing over there, the motion at the molecular level, this debris saturates over there, finds it out vent on the skin surface producing eruptions, and that's why typical eruptions on the skin in the form of a crush, in the form of a yellowish discharge, in the form of a desquamated part, it appears on the skin, and that is the calcareous cell. Then the ferrum pus, the first stage of inflammation, congestive stage, hyperemia, producing increased blood supply to any part, producing congestion, increasing blood pressure, also plays very vital role in the formation of hemoglobin, as well as it is also a remedy for leukemia. So ferrum pus again having wide spectrum application, and it is very very important remedy in number of pathologies to start with, and that's why it is common remedy you can utilize as a first aid in homeopathy. Then Kali Muraticum, the second stage of inflammation where the exudation starts, Kali Mura plays very vital role, and that's why there is a exudation from every part wherever the inflammation happens. After congestion, the exudation starts, and Ichorus plastic exudate from the ear or from any inflammatory area if it happens, or inside the joints if it happens in the form of a effusion, Kali Mura plays very vital role. And then in the yesterday's lecture we have discussed regarding the Kalifos. Kalifos is the remedy which is having again a big action right from the mind. Multiple mental problems, the psychological problems are related with the Kali Phosphoricum, including the bashfulness, including the anxiety, the depression, the obsession, all the things comes under the sphere of the Kali Phos action. Then it has very specific action on nervous system, the sensory system, the motor system, and everywhere sympathetic system, and that's why it is a good remedy to tranquilize the patient. It also supplies the, it produces nourishment to the tissues through the nerves, and that's why when it is not there, generally molecular action disturbs and patient becomes worn out, exhausted, debilitated, neuromuscular debility which happens to be there with Kali Phos. So these are the remedies which we have discussed. This is very brief description about the these remedies, and it is just a glimpse of what we have shared, I have shared. If you want to learn them by heart, go through the videos and then you can learn those very nicely. We'll start with the new remedy, Kali Sulfuricum. We have learned the first stage remedy, the ferrum pus, first stage of inflammation. Second stage of inflammation, we have learned the Kali Muraticum. The third stage, first part is covered with the calcareous salve. And second part of third stage, more pustular formation comes under the sphere of Kali Sulfuricum. So it is a potassium sulfate, Kali sulfate, formula is KSO4, and how it has been prepared, that is not of a very important issue for us. Let us go ahead with physiological chemical data. In fact, this is what we have to learn. This is very important because Kali sulf has very typical action, and you have to understand this in detail. This remedy, according to Schussler, is the function remedy of the epidermis and epithelium. See, where is the action? Action is on the skin, epidermis, epithelium, the uppermost layer. Very important, whenever you find it out the location, you can define the pathology, and that's why you get typical features in Kali sulfuricum. This remedy plays very vital role at the skin level, and it produces, even it is very important remedy for the psoriasis. It is very important remedy for the eczema. It has very specific action. What is that? A deficiency of this cell salt causes yellow slimy deposits on the tongue. In Kali Muraticum, we have discovered that there is grayish appearance on the tongue. Here it is yellowish coating on the tongue, slimy deposits. Slimy one jaka. Slimy means it is very soft. That in Marathi, we can call it as a vilvilit, bulbulit, nisarda, that is slimy deposit on the tongue, slimy, thin, and decidedly yellow or greenish discharge. Greenish discharge happens to be there because of sulfur over there. The sulfur produces oxidation whenever happens, the product becomes a greenish, and that's why any sulf which is gets attached with the with any element, it used to produce this greenish discharge. Natrum salt, you will have typical greenish discharges, and this happens because of the oxidation process which happens there with the sulfur. So greenish discharge and secretions of watery matter from any of the mucous surface. See, this is what the Kali sulf is there. If eruptions are there, there are eruptions which uses yellowish greenish discharge from them, and that is of a watery nature. And epithelial and epidermal desquamation. What is desquamation? Desquamation means it is necrosed area which is coming out, and it reflects and it falls out. That is what is the action which happens in psoriasis. And that's why Kali sulf, if you open through the 12 tissue remedies or even in borics, you will find the psoriasis in italics in Kali sulf. Even in Kali ars, it has been mentioned. These Kali salts plays very vital role in relation with the psoriasis or eczema or lichen planus. These are disorders which are quite common with the Kali salts. And this is one of the important remedy, because here with the Kali, the sulfur is attached. Sulfur, as you know, that sulfur itself have a typical action on the skin. It produces dryness, it produces number of varieties of eruptions over there, right from the papular to the pustular. All varieties, macule, papule, pustule, vesicle, all varieties you can find it out with sulfur. And when sulfur gets attached with the Kali, it produces this typical epithelial desquamation. And when it happens, think of a Kali sulf in cases of psoriasis. The yellowness is probably due to the retrograde metamorphosis. What is retrograde metamorphosis? What happens? We leave such words aside. We never think about them. Because whenever any difficult word comes, we think it is not of our need. A metamorphosis is a change. Change from one form to the another form. It is not change in complete structure, but number of times it is changed from one form to another form. So what is that retrograde metamorphosis is there? That is fatty degeneration. So you can find it out over there, the typical fatty degeneration which happens over there. A fatty degeneration manje kay? Any cell, inside the cell there is no fat content. Fat is outside the cell. But because of some changes which happens because of some reasons, that fat goes inside the cell. And when it goes, it cell fights with that, reacts with that fat, and it itself starts getting degenerated. And that's why it is called as a fatty degeneration. We used to get fatty degeneration very commonly in the liver. We get it more commonly in the heart. So this fatty degeneration of inflammatory products and effete epithelium. Effete means thakleli, worn out, exhausted. So epithelium which is worn out, exhausted, that epithelial where the fatty degeneration of inflammatory products happens to be there, it itself is responsible to produce the yellowness to the part, yellowish discharges. So that necrosed material, product of a fatty degeneration which comes out through it, either in epithelium or either in any part, typical of a Kali sulfurica. See, this is physiological chemical data. This is very important to understand why this remedy produces yellowish discharges. The reason he has mentioned over there. This is his concept regarding understanding the things at the level of a physiology. Then we'll go ahead. The sulfates in the nature and the oxide of iron serve as the oxygen carriers. Sentence is very important. Every sentence in this slide is important. See, the sulfates in the nature, nisargat aslele sulfates, and the oxide of iron, iron to oxide, serves as oxygen carriers. Both carries the oxygen. If sulfate and iron oxide comes in contact simultaneously with the organic substance in the state of decay, they give up their oxygen and sulfate of iron is formed thereby. So sulfate takes the oxygen from the iron oxide. This may again be decomposed by the oxygen of the air. So it is again decomposed by the oxygen of the air, forming sulfuric acid and iron oxide again, which under favorable conditions become again carriers of the oxygen. See, this process continues inside your body. Whenever you inhale the air. This process happens in the lungs, then it goes to the cells, again it develops over there, and that oxygen molecule gets transmitted. So this sulfur, Kali cell, plays a very vital role in this process. Similarly, similar process may occur in the human organism. This happens in the human organism again and again. And therefore, of the sulfates, Kali cell probably plays an important role because it is found in the cells as well as in the intercellular fluids, muscles, nerves, epithelium, and in the blood corpuscle. So this respiration, carrying and transforming oxygen from the intercellular to the cells and even again carrying through the vessels into the circulation, in this process Kali cell plays a very vital role. If you understand this, then you will understand where it acts. So you find it out where this Kali cell is found. It is found in cells, it is found in intercellular fluids, it is found in muscles, it is found in nerves, it is found in epithelium as well as in blood corpuscle. It is the carrier of oxygen. Underline this in your book. It is the carrier of oxygen. So if now you have understood that these are the problems which happens to, this is the action or function of a Kali cell. Now consider if this Kali cell is missing or there is a deficiency and a molecular motion is disturbed, what may be the possibility? Then automatically you can think that problems at those levels will definitely develop, and that is the pathophysiology of the Kali cell recovery. The oxygen taken up by the iron contained in the blood corpuscle is carried to every cell of the organism by the reciprocal action of Kali cell and iron. And this process happens at both the level. At the cellular level, it happens in the lungs. So this reciprocal action between Kali cell and iron continues, and oxygen molecule is transformed from one place to another place. And that is the main function of the Kali cell recovery. Every cell requires for its growth and development the vital influence of oxygen. Everyone knows that oxygen, apan tela pranvayu mhanto, it is for the development and survival of the cell, the oxygen is needed. But its continued action oxidizes the organic basis of the cells, and hence they disintegrate into their constituent element. If this oxygen happens to be there more than needed, if it is in the free form, if there are free oxygen radicals happens to be there, what happens? Then these free radicals of oxygen ultimately starts disintegrating the organism. So oxygen is also good for health and oxygen is also bad for the health. Free oxygen radicals generally affects the system, and wherever it happens that wherever they find it their pathway, they at that specific level they produces the disintegration or a destruction. And that's why if oxygen inside the body is increased, it is called as oxygenoid constitution. And oxygenoid constitution is closely related with the syphilitic miasm. And that's why oxygenoid constitution produces a destruction. So over oxygenation also produces a destruction. And that's why in allopathy they give antioxidants in their practice. They use number of antioxidants, they prescribe antioxidants. Or either they ask you to take more of the vitamin C, vitamin E, because vitamin A, all of them are antioxidants, and these are the things which are needed by the body. So both things are there. Over oxygenation also causes the destruction, less oxygenation also causes the problem. So a deficiency of a Kali cell may, according to the location and extent, occasion the following symptoms. What are the features which happens whenever there is a deficiency of a Kali cell? First important, feeling of heaviness and weariness. If oxygen supply is less, commonly this happens. When you go to high altitude and where oxygenation is less, you will find these symptoms very commonly. So feeling of a heaviness, a weariness, a vertigo, chilliness, a palpitation because it is secondary. oxygen is less in the circulation, and that's why every tissue never gets an oxygen. Ultimately, heart has to do a fast work, and palpitation is the reason. So tachycardia is quite common because of that. The fear, melancholy, fear and melancholy, these are the features which develop because the Kali part of it, that is the Kali characteristics. The phobia is the characteristic of the Kalis. Melancholy, melancholy means a sadness which is expressed on the face or body attitude is melancholy. Toothache, very important, headache, pains in the limbs, which intermits and change the location. So shifting pains is again a characteristic because it depends where there is a lacking, over there the pain develops, spasm develops. So this is very important and in understanding the Kali Sun. See, shifting pains, Kali beach, you will have shifting pains. Kali self, you will have shifting rheumatism. Why? Because this Kali self itself is carries the oxygen, and wherever there is a deficiency of oxygen, it produces a pathology over there, a disturbance over there. So it shifts, it never remains in one place, and when it shifts, it produces a pathology. This is what one has to understand. These pains are worse in a closed room. Naturally, the oxygen is lacking, pain is there, and you are in a closed room where oxygen is less, automatically the problem arises. It aggravates because of warmth and towards the evening, and better in fresh open air that is rich in oxygen. See, very clear-cut understanding of a Kali Sarva. If you read your Materia Medica, you will not get this Kali Sarva. You will get only the yellowish discharges, the psoriasis, the pathologies. But why this happens, it has been not mentioned in the Materia Medica. This is Schüssler. Schüssler is very, very thorough regarding this pathophysiology. And if you understand how these symptoms develop, you will never forget. Then you can apply them very easily. And that's why my suggestion is always that you go through this understanding the pathophysiology. Always give importance to physiology and pathology subjects. Read them again, even though you are a practitioner. I will suggest that you read them again so that you will understand how your remedy will going to work and at what level it will going to work. This understanding is very necessary. It is very essential. I will suggest one more book for you. Those who knows it, it's good. But those who don't know it, go through the Physiological Materia Medica by the Burt. It's too good, where it directly explains the primary actions of all medicines. And that those are very important to understand how these primary actions develops under the medicine. Because in our regular Materia Medica, we get the secondary actions because they are proved in dynamic levels. We have a dynamic Materia Medica because it is proved in the potencies, after potentization. And that's why we never have a primary actions, which you can get the physiological actions in Bird's book. And that's why one must study in such a manner. That ultimately indicates your study about the remedy. That is a depth of understanding of the remedy. See what he says? Epidermis and epithelial cells poorly fed with oxygen loosen and desquamate freely. So at the level of epidermis, if the cells never get a proper oxygen, they desquamate, they degenerate, necrosed. And that necrosed thing expresses itself. If the oxygen is brought to suffering parts by means of a Kali cell, if you provide Kali cell, the formation of new cells is thereby further, and these hasten by their activity to promote the desquamation of the world. So when you provide Kali cell, this part comes out, that necrosed material gets removed, and whatever is healthy that comes up, and this is how a Kali cell acts. This is physiological-chemical data about the Kali cell. I think you have understood. It is not too difficult, but we have not read it. And that's why it finds it out difficult, because we have not run, we don't have a habit of learning sentence by sentence, words by word. But this is my habit of reading any book. So this helps me a lot. Now we'll turn towards this general action of the remedy. It is only one slide is there, but if you understand it again, you can apply Kali Sarva very easily. It is applicable to the third stage of inflammation, or its stage of retrogression. the sulfates being characteristic products of the oxidation of the tissues, and potassium having its special sphere in the solids, and the resulting salt becomes prominent constituent of their ashes, whence we can infer its homeopathicity to the same stage. So what is a retrogression? Understand this word, this is very important. It is going back, it is metastasis of the condition from the surface to the internal organs. This is very important to understand. It is applicable to the third stage of inflammation or its stage of retrogression. So it is not just early stage of a third part or third stage of inflammation like a calcareous cell. It goes more than that, and that's why in third stage of inflammation the next part is covered with the Kali cell. So with inflammation you can think in this manner: the ferrum first, the first stage, the Kali Moor, the second stage, the calcareous cell, the first part of the third stage, and Kali cell is next part of the third stage of inflammation. You can find it out. Wherever there is an inflammation, just look towards it properly, you can get the answer. In case of a calcareous cell, you will not get that much of yellowness. It is just a desquamated tissue or something comes out from those eruptions, not so yellow contents of a pus or necrosis material which you can get in Kali cell furicum. So retrogression, it is metastasis of a condition from the surface to the internal organ. What he says thereafter: elements accompanied by profuse desquamation of the epidermis. And this profuse desquamation generally happens more commonly with the psoriasis, occasionally with the eczema as well as lichen planus. There are yellow mucus discharges. Rise in temperature at night, producing an evening aggravation. See, this is very important. Rise in temperature specifically at the night, producing an evening aggravation. So evening rise of temperature, that is very typical of a Kali cell furicum. Another characteristic indication is amelioration in cool open air. Because of pull of oxygenation, or because he feels better with the cool place, because sulfur is always hot, sulfur always feels better by cold, and that sulfur is associated with the Kali over here, and that's why the typical modality of a sulfur is applied over here. This is caused by a retrocession of the eruptions. So eruptions which are which appears over there, which starts retrocession or it goes back, produces degeneration, exfoliating and coming out in the form of little bit desquamated layers of it. Those are very typical of the Kali cell furicum. To produce perspiration, if ferrum first fails, Kali cell is the remedy. Generally, fever disappears whenever perspiration comes. So if you have given ferrum pus and if it is not working to reduce the temperature, he says that this is one more remedy you can try for that, because it might have gone first stage of inflammation and enter into that. So this is general action of the remedy. And now we'll turn towards the last part, out of which this homeopathic data, as this remedy you can get in Allen's encyclopedia as well as hearing guiding symptoms. Administration is important. Schussler recommends 12x and 6x, these giving the best results. In febrile conditions, it must be given frequently. It is recommended externally in dandruff and diseases of the scalp. I don't have an experience of external application. Often completes a cure commenced by the Kali Moor. This is simple logic, because Kali Moor starts with second stage and Kali cell ends with the third stage, and that's why those cases where cure is not yet completed, you have given Kali Moor, add Kali Sarp and complete the cure. This is logical application of it. Relationship, understanding the relationship is important, because it is Kali sulfuricum in relation with number of remedies. Those are very very essential to understand. Nearest analog to the Kali Sarp appears to be pulsatilla, and that is called as vegetable analog is always a pulsatilla. Why it is so? The reason is very important. It is interesting to compare these two remedies, as they have many symptoms in common. Thus, both have aggravation of the symptoms in warm room. Pulsatilla, we know, aggravation in warm room. Calicelp is also aggravation in warm room. Ameliration in cool and open air, both remedies. Discharges from the mucous membranes are yellow, purulent in character, and sometimes yellowish green. Both remedies are having them. So, see the similarity in both remedies, and that's why they are called as a vegetable analog or a chemical analog subsequently, that you can understand. Coating of the tongue, yellow and slimy, both remedies having that feature. Pressure and feeling of a coolness in the stomach. It is present in Pulsatilla, it is present in Calicelphiricum. Pulsatilla never tolerates the farinaceous food. Gonorrhea with yellow or yellowish green bland discharge. Again, common features of the both the remedy. Yellow mucus expectoration from the lungs and on coughing. This is again present in both remedies. Hoarseness from simple cold. So, patient catches a cold and their hoarseness develops. Again, a feature of both remedies. Pains in the limbs, worse at night and from warmth, and better by cold and better by cool place or open air. It is present in Pulsatilla, it is present in Calicelphiricum. See the similarity at number of levels. Palpitation of the heart, again two remedies present over there. Migratory or shifting and wandering rheumatic pains. Just now we have learned it is in Calicel and both it is also present in Pulsatilla. Pulsatilla is remedy for changeability and you have this shifting rheumatism in Pulsatilla. This is very important. All those features are very similar to each other in both remedy. And why it is so? He gives a reason over there. A chemical analysis of Pulsatilla shows that one of its constituents is Calicelphiricum. Another is Caliphos and another is Calcareophos. Three important ingredients are present in Pulsatilla plant. What are they? Calicelp is there, Caliphos is there and Calcareophos is there. And see, Schussler have then done that study and he explains why these three remedies features is accumulated in the Pulsatilla. It is present in Pulsatilla. And then he compares it. Its mucus symptoms probably are due to the presence of Calicel. So whatever the mucus symptoms are there, the yellowish discharges, yellowish expectoration or greenish yellowish discharges, it's because of Calicel. Then he says its mental and nervous symptoms of the Pulsatilla are due to the Caliphos. You know Pulsatilla better than me. You know that Pulsatilla is a lady who doesn't have courage, who is dependent, who is weeping, causes weeping, causeless weeping, more emotional, more sensitive, more touchy, more depressed, doesn't have courage, indecisive. All those things are very typical with the Pulsatilla, which we know. And see that those symptoms are very commonly present in Calicelphiricum. We have learned yesterday the Calicelphiricum. All those features are there in Calicelphos. Even nervous symptoms of the Calicelphos, they are also present in the Pulsatilla. So, this is another level, the Pulsatilla is similar to Caliphos. But of course, this is pure hypothesis and only suggested for further study and observation. Very important thing he mentions, this is my understanding, this is my hypothesis. It may be the reason because of which the similarity is there. And what he says, it requires further study. To whom he is saying, it has been said for you, for us. For what purpose? Because such type of research gives you details regarding the understanding the homeopathic Materia Medica with more aspect and more detailed aspect. And this type of study should be done in with the homeopathy. Calicelphiricum often follows with advantage Calimuraticum. See, this is very important sentence. If you have given Calimur, patient is not getting completely cured, give Calicelphiricum which completes the action and clears the case. These are the hints one should not forget while learning the remedy. Calicelphiricum, I used to use this remedy very commonly in the skin ailments, specifically in the psoriasis more commonly. It is also present in biocombination number 20, which is skin affections. And Calicelp is one of the important ingredient of it. So, Kalisal plays very vital role over there. The compatible remedies in itching and redness of the skin are acetic acid, arsenic, calcareca, the dolichos, heparsulfuricum, the pulsatilla, the rustox, sepia, silica, sulfur and artica yellow. It is for you. You must study the kalisulfuricum, the itching and redness of the skin in relation with these remedies, so that you can understand the differences between them and you can consider those remedies according to the eruption. So at the end of every chapter, he used to explain you or give the relationship, and he says this study should be done, this comparison should be done, so that your knowledge of Amatra Medica enriches. And what he says at last, it's compare Natramya in deafness with the Kali Sulfuricum. Compare Natramya with pain in stomach, coarse RALS. RALS means it is the expectoration which is saturated over there, producing a typical sound, a rough sound, crepitation like sound on auscultation. Those are RALS, which if a patient coughs, you can listen them sometimes. That patient, it is congested. Kalisulf is one of the important remedy. Don't forget. Generally what happens, we used to think of antimtat very easily because it is a rattling cough. But if it is yellowish mucus expectoration is there, or yellowish greenish expectoration is there, think of Kalimuraticum as a remedy over there. So what he says, coarse RALS and profuse exudations. Exudations, it is a profuse protein rich fluid which is comes out. So second, third stage of inflammation is profuse exudation. But these are more watery in natrum. So there is comparison. As compared to the Kalisulfuricum, these discharges are more watery in nature in natrum. Comparatively, they are quite viscid in case of natrum Kalisulfuricum. So this is the comparison of these two drugs which he mentions over there. So this is a Kalisulfuricum which we have learned. I will share one case and then we'll conclude the session. There was a patient who was brought to me around 35-36 years old male with a typical all over body. He had eruptions and which were oozing yellowish, and along with that he was having a chronic bronchitis. He was continuously on antibiotics since long time, and antibiotics, bronchitis.